Hello and welcome to Amity TV. Today, I am Dipali Gautam and we have a very special guest with us, Mr. Joseph Paul, who is a manager at IIT Patna Incubation Center. We welcome you to Amity TV, sir. So we would like to know from you that what are your experiences at the Indian startup business in India?
Okay. So I have been associated with a startup company when I joined IT industry. And that company has grown big and has gone into the international market also. So though I was a part of that company as an employee, I have been part of the journey of the company. The company has grown from 20 people to 500 people and few lakh rupees to 300 crores now at this time. So after spending 17 years in that company, I switched to a startup sector itself. Now I support companies as part of my work in the incubation center at IIT Patna, where we have supported till now about 60 companies for developing their products and going into the market.
Thank you so much, sir. So my next question is, sir, that as you have an experience of 20 years, so what are the advancements and enhancements that you have noticed in the startup ideas of the people over a period of time?
Yeah. India has not been a big, startup center earlier. And most of the startups were in the field of software and mostly software services. So over a period of time, people have realized that software services is not the only thing that we can do, which is primarily working on a body selling model, in the sense that you offer services of people, so which can only be scaled by increasing the number of people employed. So subsequently, people started thinking about coming up with startups which are product oriented, where you consolidate the value and you can scale in a disproportionate manner. So many product companies have started coming up, and India has become very successful in software products also. I don't know whether you are aware of it, because most of our software products are not consumer oriented. They are mostly enterprise oriented. There are one of the best billing solutions in the world. When I say billing solution, the software that you use to price and bill the mobile transactions, banking transactions, stuff like that. One of the world leading companies is from India. There is another company which is into the travel and logistics part, which facilitates airports to function. That company is also from India. They have a product. They are one of the world leaders in that product. There is another company which is into revenue assurance and fraud management. So when you have a lot of online transactions going on in internet, there is a lot of fraud that happens, especially in corporate banking and other things. So fraud detection and management is a huge requirement for companies. So the world leader in that sector also is from India. So they are all product-based companies, which is like a second wave of startup companies. Subsequently, due to government's efforts in promoting manufacturing and hardware-oriented companies, slowly, the momentum is coming up in hardware sector, hardware manufacturing, especially with the advent of Internet of Things. A lot of companies are coming up in that area as well. So we can see that we started with less infrastructure intensive, knowledge-oriented work, to now infrastructure intensive and IP intensive, intellectual property intensive work. So there is a positive shift. We need to be good in everything.
Yes, sir, yes. For sure. So, what are the challenges that you face while you are mentoring the people? Because as we know, you're already involved in so many other sectors. So, what are the challenges that you face in day-to-day life?
Challenges, when you work with an established organization or a company where the systems are already there, you have a standard way of working. So you go and you know what you need to do. When you work with startup companies, you don't know sometimes what you need to do, because they have different challenges daily. That is one, and you need to help them with those challenges. sometimes you may not be aware of those challenges yourself. So one thing is, constant learning, that is necessary, and the uncertainty of circumstances that might come up. Second challenge is the number of stakeholders. In an established organization, if you're working, then you have a set of customers to work with or a set of colleagues to work with. When you're working with startups, you have a large number of startups to work with, and everyone is doing different things. So adapting to everybody's, a frequency of interaction, the communication style, personality, their company's circumstances, industry, sector requirements. So you constantly have to switch back and forth between different sectors, different issues, different type of personalities. So that sometimes put pressure on you, but it is okay, part of the game.
Thank you so much for such inspiring words, sir. I'm sure our audience must have taken a great lesson and they will apply that to their future ventures. Thank you for watching Amity TV. Stay tuned for more updates.